These are uncertain times, and as COVID-19 pandemic demonstrated, life can change very quickly. And losing a family member is the worst thing to happen in these trying times. This pain becomes even more unbearable if the family member in question happens to be the sole breadwinner. The passing of the breadwinner leaves the finances of a family in shambles. And if the nominations are not in place,
it becomes terribly difficult for the heirs to get access to the deceased investments,
including bank accounts, demat accounts, mutual funds, and even insurance policies. Hi, I'm Sukanya Roy, and through this video, we will explain you what happens to the investments when the holder dies without nominating anyone. Okay, so now let's take a look at the procedures to be followed in such cases for getting access to the money locked up in financial instruments. Unlocking in the absence of nomination.
Number 1. Banking.
Well, the nominee is someone designated by the depositor to act as the trustee of the bank account when the latter dies. In the absence of nomination, several things come into play.
A. If the account is operated as either a survivor, then the survivor may claim the deposit. If it is operated jointly, meaning that all account holders need to sign for the withdrawals, then the bank will usually pay the proceeds out jointly to the surviving holder and the legal heirs of the deceased. B. In case it is singly operated account, then the heirs may have to present the will of the deceased to stake their claim on the asset. C. In the event of the demise of all holders and when nomination is not updated in the accounts, the funds lying in the accounts of the deceased are settled as per the mandate given by the legal heirs after establishing their identity. D. Upon successful submission of claim documents by the legal heirs and subject to its verification by the bank, the claim is settled to all the legal heirs of the deceased holders or any one of them mandated by all.
Please do remember that in all cases, the claimants will have to make an application and submit it along with a copy of the account holder's death certificate, the claim form, and the address proof and ID of each claimant.
If there are several heirs and the assets have to be transferred to only one of them, then the other will have to sign a disclaimer relinquishing all rights to the assets in favor of the claimant. Number 2. Insurance. In the absence of a nominee, the legal heirs can claim the sum assured.
However, you will need to present these documents: a claim intimation letter, death certificate, ID proof of the beneficiary, policy papers, discharge form if any, post-mortem report, and hospital records in case of unnatural death.
But sometimes the insurer would require a succession certificate issued by the court specifically mentioning the policy number and the amount to be paid.
But remember, the absence of nomination can create difficulties for your family, as getting a succession certificate from the court is easier said than done.
Number 3. Mutual funds. The procedure required the heirs to first produce certain documents,
including death certificate, PAN card and KYC acknowledgement of the claimants, documents providing their relationship to the deceased, and transmission form.
After that, the process will vary slightly based on whether the transmission amount is above or below 2 lakh rupees.
Well, probate is the term for a legal process in which a will is reviewed to determine whether it is valid and authentic.
If for transmission the amount is more than 2 lakh rupees, apart from individual affidavits, production of a succession certificate or probate or letter of administration is mandatory, as against a bond of indemnity. Upon transmission, the unit stands as a valid discharge by the asset management company. Number 4. Demat account.
Well, in case the demat account holder hadn't nominated anyone in his lifetime,
any transmission of the securities from the demat account will be made to the legal heirs.
In compliance with the provisions or procedures laid down in the bylaws of the respective depository participants.
Now, depository participants generally insist on certain documents prior to making any transmission of the security lying in the demat account. If the value of the securities exceeds 5 lakh rupees, then the claimant must provide a copy of the probate of the will or attested or notarized copy of letter of administration or a duly attested or notarized copy of the succession certificate or an order of a competent court to support their legal claim, along with the transmission request, copy of death certificate and client master report of the demat account of the claimant.
If you like this video, share it and subscribe to Business Standard. For more news, views and insights, log on to www.business-standard.com.